Hello, and welcome to week 79 of Heatmageddon. Oh, Jesus, lads, I feel like I'm living in a dystopian film. Yesterday evening, I was walking back from Dad's, and there's something about the time of the day that I'm coming back from there, and that particular road, I think I must be facing extreme west, because I am walking into the sun, and it's all concrete, it's sort of white concrete, and the heat is bouncing back at me, and the whiteness, the glare, and there's no trees nor nothing to give me a bit of shelter, you know. And I was walking along and thinking, is this what it's like to live in the Saudi Arabias? And thinking, are Saudi Arabian women better able for the heat, the great heat, than I am? Or is it just as awful for them, you know? And squivilization is breaking down. Like, you heard about the bird incident when I was there scribing away good old one day during the week, and I had the window open a little bit. Now, Irish people in general don't do open windows. We just don't, and I don't know why. Maybe it's just because we never really had cause to. It was mostly about keeping out the driving rain and not getting your house flooded. Anyway, I had the window open and in flies a bird. And people kept saying to me afterwards, the bird was probably more scared than you. The bird was not more scared than me. I was really scared, and the bird was real cheeky and swaggery and going around and looking at my things and going, oh yeah, is that good? And would you be putting that on every day? And looking at my makeup and things, and going into my drawers and looking at my skincare, and it was all very alarming. And so I screamed the house down, and because I'm not good with wildlife, like I'm not good with beasts in any way, because I've never had a dog nor nothing like that, or a pet. And So it traumatised me terribly, and then I was afraid to have the windows open, and then I was afraid that wasn't enough just to keep the windows closed. So then I went and I nailed up all the windows, and then I bricked them up. But then on Friday, now I'll tell you about Fridays. Fridays are different now, because do you remember we used to go to Old Vumman's for Friday? And then Old Vumman decided that it didn't suit her. Oh yeah, it didn't suit Dad, that's what it was. And that we weren't to come to her anymore, and we were to come here. And we were all very sorrowful, the end of an era and everything. And then Old Vumman said, but then we had to go to Herd's for the birthdays. Now, because there's so many of us, we have a birthday most weeks. So we ended up going to Herd's, I don't know, for 3 weeks in a row or something like that. And then there wasn't a birthday, and I said, well, we'll be going to my house on the Friday. She goes, oh, why? And I said, because you said we were to. And she goes, but no, that was only when. You see, and Old Vumman is very canny. Old Vumman does not admit to things that don't suit her, do you know? So then we were going there again. And then two things happened. Thing one, Redzard the Elder took up karate. That's what I'm calling it. It's karate. On a Friday. So they weren't able to come. And then Old Vumman says she's going to bridge on a Friday at 7 o'clock, and we can't come to hers. And I said, but we can lock up afterwards. And she goes, no, I wouldn't be able to trust ye. I wouldn't be able to concentrate on the bridge, because some of ye go out the back to smoke. Now I'm naming no names, but you come back in and you don't lock the back door. So now we're here on a Friday. And then so the babies arrived on Friday to discover all the windows bricked up and everything, and no light nor nothing. And they said, what's going on? So I explained that we had to keep the birds at bay. And they said, yeah, but Teddy wants to go out into the garden. So we had to unblock the windows. And then another feckin' bird comes in. And then I'm getting reports on Twitters of birds of prey, like flying into windows. Kay on Twitter, her window was broken be a buzzard. And I think it's something to do with the weather. And this is another sign that we are in Heatmageddon. And it is all awful. And it's never going to end. I'm quite comfortable with that now. It is never going to end. It is just going to stay like this forever until we all die of hate. And what can you do? It is our own fault for burning the fossil fuels and that sort of thing. Even though I do walk round to Dad, and it isn't really my fault at all. And I didn't learn to drive till I was 36. And I don't know really why people can be blaming me, because I don't really use the fossil fuels at all, really. Not much. Maybe not. Anyway, I got clogs. Hold on till I show you. Can you see my lovely silver clogs? They are from a brand called Lotto. Is it Lotto or Lotta? They're Swedish, and it was Kathy Sanderson who told me about them. And they are like has-beens, only much cheaper. Also silver. I like silver shoes. I love silver shoes. They don't have to be real silver. They can be plate. Is that the word? Plate. Yes. Anyway, look at. On we trudge, beaten down by the sun on our head and our brains leaking out our ears and the great misery and the great narkiness. I am as narky. But powerless. Powerless and narky and too hot. I hope you're okay. There's plenty of people who are loving this. I hope you are one of them. I do not wish my misery on other people. I don't. Goodbye.